Okay guys, welcome back to the channel. Now today what I've got for you lot is FIFA 21 player ratings, finally the juicy stuff, the stuff that we actually care about. None of that stadium stuff, none of that customizable stuff. This is the actual FIFA 21 official player ratings. Now I do this every year, so if you know how I do it, I'm just going to recap anyway. We're going to go over the ratings. I don't know how many ratings they've actually shown us, because normally it's like 10 at a time or 15 at a time. But I don't know, maybe it says see top 100, so maybe they've shown us all the top 100. But we'll go over each player. I'll obviously say what I think about the card, if it's deserved or not. Let me know down in the comments below as well what you think of each card, what you think, if you disagree, agree with anything as well. And you know what, I don't want to waste any more time, let's get straight into it, man. See top 100, let's go. What we saying? So, how we doing this here? I mean, the site is going to be quite laggy, to be fair, because of... they've given in-game stats as well, you know? Wait, hold up. More FIFA 21 player rating, best 20... Okay, whoa. Didn't want to see that. Shit, I think they've put everyone in, you know? I think they've put every single card in. So the highest rated player is Lionel Messi, and straight away they've downgraded cards heavy this year. Heavy. Bloody hell, man. Oh shit in hell. Okay, so the highest rated card is 93. 85 pace. 95 dribbling still up there. I believe that's a minus one in shooting and a minus two on passing. 80 sprint speed. Oh my. Medium low still. Four star. Obviously left footed. His four star weak foot has never felt like a four star weak foot though as well. At least last year. Can we look at player ratings? So I like how they've used in-game stats. That is phenomenal. That is absolutely brilliant. Right, 95 vision, what did it? 91 agility, but what's happened to his shooting? So I'm guessing his shooting's been downgraded, because of what, shot power? 86 shot power for Lionel Messi. I'm a Ronaldo guy, but I don't care about all that shit. How the hell are you going to give Lionel Messi an 86? I don't want to waste your time, but I'm just going to say what I need to and keep it real. Stamina 72, he's already had a stamina problem in FIFA anyway, but 93 is the highest overall, and he's still a right wing. 85 pace, I don't know if I agree with that, and I don't know if I agree with 86 shooting as well. But it looks like they're toning down player ratings this year, and stats as well. I mean, if Lionel Messi is 85 pace, Ronaldo's probably going to be about what? I'm going to guess like 85 as well, probably. 89 pace. Okay, so Ronaldo gets maybe like a minus one. I wonder if there's an easier way to look at these, because, again, like I said, the stats are... I mean, the website is quite loaded. As you can see, so many people are probably trying to access this right now. Okay, we're just going to go back. We don't want to see Ronaldo. All right, that's kind of... Okay, there you go, my bad. So he's still got the 5-star skill move, still a striker, which is beautiful. Obviously, minus 1 downgrade, because I feel like everyone's got a minus down, 1 downgrade. 5-star skill move, 4-star weak foot, high, low. Perfect. 89 pace, which is dealable. But I'm surprised they gave Messi a higher pace downgrade than Cristiano Ronaldo, which I don't know about that, man. I'm not sure about that, but anyway... 87 acceleration, 95 finishing, 95 positioning. Oh, this card is so nice. It looks like it's going to be another Ronaldo year, boys, honestly. I mean, passing is sufficient enough. We'll have to see what the gameplay is like, but if it's anything like FIFA 20, hopefully it's not. But for that, passing is sufficient. 87 agility for a guy who's 6'2", I believe, or 6'1". 95 reaction is perfect. 95 composure, brilliant. 84 stamina is decent enough for the start of the game. I mean, if you can, you know, if you can afford Ronaldo at the start of the game, 84 stamina, like I said, 78 strength, 95 jumping. That's a very nice card, man. Very nice, well-rounded card. Much better than Lionel Messi on FIFA 21, I should say, card stats-wise, but we'll have to see how the game plays, obviously. My boy, Robert Lewandowski, robbed off a Ballon d'Or as well, you know. I'll never forget this. I'll never forget this. But again, I can't really remember his pace. I believe it was 81 maybe. So I don't count me on that. Don't quote me on that. But I believe it was 81. So it's gone down to 78. Four star, high media work rates. Right footed, obviously. 77 acceleration, 78 sprint speed. We'll have to see how much pace plays a part in the new FIFA. 94 finishing, definitely deserved. 94 positioning, definitely deserved. Shot power, I'd probably say a little bit high, maybe. Penalties, 88. 85 free kicks, 84 shot passing. Very good shot passing for a striker. Curves a little low. Agility is a little low as well. 82 balance as well. Not the best, obviously, not known for his agility and balance like a little Insigne or Alejandro Gomez or something like that. 85 in-game dribbling. 85 in-game dribbling? Pretty sure he had higher than that, maybe. 88 composure, possibly should have been in the 90s, in my opinion. 76 stamina, again, not sure how it was in FIFA 20 for his base card, but 86 strength is brilliant as well. And he's also got 81 aggression. This all depends on how much pace is a factor in the new game. But again, Robert Lewandowski coming in as a 91 overall. Next up, we have Kevin De Bruyne. Now, oh shit, I've done it again. I've fucking done it again. My play rating prediction was pretty much on point apart from the overall. Obviously, you can't predict what they're going to do with the overall, if they're going to boost them up or boost them down. Downgrade players in terms of overall. But there you have Kevin De Bruyne, still keeps his 5-star weak foot, 4-star skill moves, high work rate, right footed, of course. Pretty much a similar card, man. Pretty much a similar card to this year. I get it, they can't put him to a 92 because then that would put him on Ronaldo levels. But I don't know, I still think Messi should be like a 94. They should have kept the old rating style. 94 Messi, 92 Ronaldo, you know. And then, you know, Robert Lewandowski as a 91. Kevin De Bruyne maybe as a 92. But yeah, Kevin De Bruyne, like I said, 82 finishing, 91 long shots. And shot power as well. Possibly should have been higher, man. He scored some bangers. Perfect passing. Brilliant composure and dribbling stats. Apart from the agility and balance. Stamina is perfect as well. 89 suits him perfectly. 74 strength and aggression at 76. Possibly could be higher as well. But that's a brilliant card. Even as a centre mid as well. With the boosted, I believe, defending stats. 64. That seems like an upgrade to me. 66 interceptions, you could gladly play him as a centre mid. 68 marking as well, definitely, 100%. That's a banging card. Really, really well-rounded card for the start of the game. Next up, we have none other than Neymar with a minus one downgrade as well. You know, I nearly did it again. Five star, still stays the five star. One of my favourite cards in FIFA 20. One of the cards that made the game enjoyable for me. He's just so good, and it seems like even though he has had a minus one downgrade, I believe that's minus two shooting on the base card stats, probably a minus one in dribbling as well, I want to say, and a minus one on pace, just off the top of my head. But again, very good pace, 94 acceleration, 87 finishing, I believe he keeps that as well from FIFA 20. Good passing, I believe his passing stats look fairly the same in terms of short passing and long passing. Brilliant dribbling, man. This guy on the ball, no matter what FIFA, he's just going to be so good because of his body type in game, and the 95 in-game dribbling, composure, ball control, agility, so good. 81 stamina seems about the same as last year as well. Again, even though he's got a downgrade, this card looks absolutely phenomenal. Honestly, absolutely top tier. Jan Oblak, I mean, there's nothing really to say about goalkeepers, but I believe Jan Oblak keeps his rating from a 91 overall as well from FIFA 20. Virgil van Dijk. Fun fact, I don't believe I use Virgil van Dijk in FIFA 20. Yeah, I know, right? Fucking hell. I don't remember using Virgil van Dijk in FIFA 20. It's just, I didn't want to fall into the mainstream trend. But medium work rates for Virgil van Dijk. Again, very good pace for a centre-back, especially at the start of the game. 76 pace, very good passing. Composure brilliant, interception brilliant, decent in-game dribbling at 70, especially for the start of the game. Like I said, brilliant reaction, good ball control, phenomenal defending stats. Stamina doesn't really matter that much, but 75 is still decent. 92 strength, 83 aggression. That is brilliant. Is that a strength downgrade? Possibly. I could be wrong. Like I said, I could be wrong. But yeah, that's that. So, Kylian Mbappe, obviously a poster boy. So I knew he was going to get an upgrade. Once you're a poster boy, obviously you do get these upgrades. But that is a banger. Kylian Mbappe, striker, 90 overall. Literally on path to being one of the greatest of all time if he keeps it up, man. Like, this kid is, his potential is unmatched, unrivaled. And again, 5-star skill moves, striker, 4-star weak foot, high low is what you want from your striker as well. Like, literally blistering pace, finish at 91, shot. Do I need to say anything? Composure is quite low, to be fair. Composure's quite low at 84, so that could be a problem. I mean, it wasn't really the highest in FIFA 20 as well, but I guess his other stats made up for that. 92 agility. Him and Neymar on one wing is pretty much illegal. 76 strength, 86 stamina as well. Like, what more do you want me to say? What more do you want me to say? Mo Salah, has he still got that weak foot downgrade? He does. 3-star weak foot still for Mo Salah. 93 pace, 90 dribbling, 86 shooting. Again, very well-rounded card. It's just that 3-star weak foot which puts me off a little bit. Composure, dribbling, brilliant. Passing, decent enough for a winger. Pace, acceleration, shooting is absolutely top tier. Stamina is brilliant for a winger at 85. Again, for the start of the game. 75 strength as well is very good for a guy who's, I believe, like 5'9", I want to say, 5'10", maybe. So, that again, that's a very good card apart from the 3-star weak foot. My guy, the person who I prefer, who I say is the best Liverpool attacker, in my opinion, this guy, Sadio Mane, unbelievable. Had the pleasure of packing his Team of the Year card last year. On stream as well, 4-star, high, medium, right foot. You know what I mean? Like, this guy is balanced. Pace, he's got the shooting, he's got the passing, he's still got the dribbling. Again, 84 composure. I'm not sure again what his composure was last year, but 84 composure seems a little low. That probably is a downgrade in my opinion. I could be wrong though, again. 88 stamina, very good. 75 aggression. This guy's going to be brilliant. Honestly, very good. Very fucking good. He's definitely going to be worth more than Mo Salah. Just because of that 4-star weak foot as well. Playing a part. Andre Ter Stegen keeps his rating as a 90. Obviously known as probably the most overpowered goalkeeper in all of FIFA 20 for the longest time. We also have Alisson again up to a 90. I believe that's a plus 1 overall upgrade on Alisson. Sergio Ramos, my guy. Stays at an 89, I believe. I want to say 89. Man, it's been so long since I played FIFA 20, honestly. So, apologies if I've got some of these ratings wrong from the previous years. But again, good enough pace. 71 is decent enough. Man, you could probably play this guy as a CDM. I mean, I know high medium isn't really what you want to go for as a CDM. Especially as a centre-back as well. Apologies. Shit, my voice is going. But obviously, he has that nice penalty boost upgrade because he did score a lot of penalties for Real Madrid this season. Again, very, very good passing. Very good dribbling. Top-tier dribbling for a defender, especially a centre-back. 85 marking, not the best, but again, not the worst. 88 stand tackle, 90 slide tackle, 93 jumping, 85 strength. And he's definitely got that aggression at 90. He definitely know that. Brilliant card once more. Manuel Neuer an 89 as well. I believe that's a plus 1 upgrade. Sergio Aguero gets a pace downgrade for sure. He's at 78. I do not remember Aguero getting a 78 pace, being 78 pace in FIFA 20. So that's definitely a downgrade. 4-star though. Brilliant shooting. again, he's just going to be one of them nifty guys. He's just going to be a slower, probably a false nine type of player in FIFA 21. Just because of that pace, because he's got that shooting, he's got decent passing, right? 83 short pass, he's got the finishing at 94, positioning at 94 as well, decent curve, and he's got brilliant dribbling, 91 composure, 88 in-game dribbling, 89 ball control, 91 balance, 84 agility. Stamina's decent, strength is decent as well, because he has got a stocky build in-game, so that'll help him a lot. But yeah, Sergio Aguero, decent card, but kind of a shame that he's got a pace downgrade. I actually agree with the pace downgrade. I can't remember a lot of times where I've seen Aguero fully, you know, go side by side and sprint against a defender and actually outpace them. Again, I don't watch City a lot. Obviously, City's not my team, but generally speaking, I just can't really picture Aguero really pacing someone. But yeah. Karim Benzema deserves an upgrade, definitely, for his contributions to Real Madrid that last season. He played absolutely brilliant, but I believe he has got a pace downgrade again. Similar player to Sergio Aguero, apart from the medium low work rate that he has. 90 positioning, apologies. 88 finishing, which is very nice. 86 short pass, very good. Again, he's another false nine type of player. Less agile as than Aguero, sorry. 79 agility, 69 balance. So he's going to feel kind of clunky on the ball, especially at the start of the game. But he's got very good composure. I'm not going to lie. It all depends on how the gameplay is. A player like Karim Benzema might actually work because, again, he's tall. He's got that nice little, you know, he's got like a, not a stocky build, but he's got like an average build in-game. He's also got the 4-star, 4-star. He's got very good dribbling apart from the agility and balance. He can shoot. He can pass. So, again, it depends on how the gameplay is. So, we can't really judge. But overall, just looking at his stats, he seems like not my type of player, if I'm being 100% honest with you. Another player that's not really one of my type of players is Casemiro. I believe that's another upgrade to 89. High work rates. Again, I'm not gonna lie to you lot. Not going to use Casemiro, especially when he's got higher work rates as a CDM. I like my CDMs to have maximum, like as a minimum. It needs to be medium high. I need a medium high. But again, 84 short pass, 84 long pass, decent at the start of the game. Vision's kind of low at 80. Composure's decent at 84 for a CDM. Good interceptions, good reactions. Again, very clunky on the ball. Motherfucker's going to move like Starscream. 84 marking, again, not the best, but it's decent, I guess, for the start of the game. I don't see Casemiro going for tons of money just because he, even though he has got very good defensive stats and aggression and physical stats, not the best of dribbling, let's be honest. Decent passing apart from vision, just because he's got that very slow pace at 65, was it? Yeah, he's not going to really be favourable, but again, maybe because of his rating, could be. But I really doubt it. I really doubt it. Thibaut Courtois has an 89 overall as well. I believe that's a plus one upgrade as well. So these Real Madrid players, how many Real Madrid players have we seen? We've seen about, what, a good five? Ramos, there's three there. We've got five in the top 20. Toni Kroos coming in as an 88 as well. But first of all, can I just say, this is definitely deserved, right? Joshua Kimmich, oh, he's got a high medium. Shit. Ah, he's got a high medium. This guy's a baller, man. Honestly, literally, Bayern Munich couldn't have found a better replacement if they wanted to for Philipp Lahm when he retired. Joshua Kimmich is a bad man. I don't even care. This guy is such a world-class baller. It's unreal. Unreal. 4-star weak for 3-star skill move. The only thing I don't like about this is the high medium. But other than that, let's see his stats. 77 acceleration, much better than Casemiro already, even though his sprint speed isn't there. We don't care about shooting, really, because he's a CDM. Passing is where... This is what you want from your CDM. This is what you want. 84 vision, much better than Casemiro already. Brilliant crossing because he was a fullback. And that ball that he pointed to Kingsley Coman in the Champions League final. Oof. 87 short pass, 87 long pass, 85 curve. Brilliant dribbling, keeping in mind that he is a short player as well. Side tackle isn't the best. Standing tackle, again, 84 marking, 82. Obviously not better in terms of defensive capabilities. than Casemiro because he's obviously maxed out. A very good aggression. But with a Kem style, and depending on how effective they are, he's going to be very good, man. He's going to be very good. Toni Kroos, I believe he's been shafted in pace again. Still keeps his 5-star week for. His passing is going to be unreal because this motherfucker is still top 10 centre mids in the world, if not top 5. His passing is unreal, but it's a shame players like Toni Kroos in FIFA aren't usable because, again, pace. Again, dribbling is not really the best. 18-game dribbling, and he's going to move like an absolute ice cream van. Stamina, 75. Strength, 73. You know, it's not the best. So, again, he's going to be like Casemiro, going to be avoided at all costs. I'm quite curious to see how many ratings we have here because this might be a long-ass video. If this is actually the whole database, top 100 ratings, man, I might need to go quicker than this. I don't want to waste your lot's time. We're just going to skim through them now. Harry Kane, high work rates, pace downgrade, 2 overall downgrade, which is kind of harsh, I'm not going to lie to you. 93 positioning, 94 shot power, very good passing for a striker, very good shooting. Again, kind of reminds me of Benzema, even though Benzema's kind of much better in the dribbling category because Kane's got 80 dribbling. Very good physicals for Kane as well, 84 strength, 84 stamina. Very good aggression at 81 as well because he's like 6'2", I believe. Again, probably just worse than Benzema and Aguero just because of that pace and the dribbling. I don't see him being used again, and it's kind of harsh seeing him because he was out injured for quite a bit. But -2 for Kane. Eden Hazard gets a -3, I believe, and it's definitely deserved. I don't care. I'll take the stick for this. I don't care. It's definitely deserved. Motherfucker has done absolutely nothing. I believe he was injured as well, so they're being consistent with it, at least. If they're going to give Kane the downgrade, they'll give Hazard the downgrade as well. Four-star. Again, 82 finishing, quite a big downgrade. He's only got 82 shooting this year. I believe it was 84 last year, probably. Again, Eden Hazard, don't get me wrong, he's going to be brilliant in FIFA 20, especially at the start. Dribbling is off the charts, like Neymar level, but obviously in-game it's not going to be as good, I don't believe. Passing is very good, it's just the shooting that isn't brilliant, but again, for the start of the game, that's brilliant. Eden Hazard's still going to go for a lot of money. He's still got a pace, decently enough pace, very good dribbling, decent shooting for the start of the game, especially for a winger, and decent passing as well, so you can't really complain at that. Raheem Sterling, his weak foot is going to be terrible, and his composure and finishing should be down in the bin. Let's see if it is. 3-star weak foot, yep. Oh, Raheem Sterling is 26 now, bro. Mad. Very good pace, lightning quick, 96 acceleration, 85 finishing! What? I mean, yes, he did have his highest goal scoring tally for City, but fam, some of the misses, sitters he missed, like his composure has to be low. 80, bro, I'd put that at 70, and that's being generous. So 85 finishing, which is very good for a winger, to be fair. He's lacking the shot power and long shots. Again, I don't want to keep saying this, but it depends on how effective they are. Crossing isn't really that good as well, especially being from the left side and having a 3-star weak foot. Stamina's decent at 79. Composure's dog shit, but dribbling is very good, and that seems like a very, very, very good card as well, especially from the left side being right footed. Dybala coming in as an 88 overall as well. Centre forward, again, still keeps that 3-star weak foot, which is a shame. But a very well-rounded card again, like last year, man. Like, Dybala wasn't used that much. I don't remember coming up against the Dybala very much. And that composure stat seems to be very consistent at 84. They like that. But again, very, very well-rounded card, man. Nothing really more to say. I'd probably play this card as a cam just because, I mean, he's got that good short pass. He's got that very good vision at 87. He's got decent finishing for a cam, especially at the start of the game, and he's got that 4-star, 3-star, so them skill moves will help out a cam as well. So Dybala, medium work rates as well, decent, but more suited to a cam in my opinion. Edison stays at an 88. N'Golo Kante, one of the best CDMs in FIFA 20 as well, as always, medium high work rates, again, perfect. Actually, that's a downgrade by one, right? N'Golo Kante, I believe he was an 89. pace downgraded as well. I believe it might have been 81. But again, honestly, I don't need to go over Kante. He's going to be OP as always. 96 stamina. Like, perfect. Defensive stats. He's just what you want. 91 interceptions is stupid. Kante is still going to go for mad P. And he'll probably be the go-to CDM again. Who else have we got? Handanovic stays at a 88. Koulibaly, quickly skim over him as well. Medium high work rates, which is perfect. Obviously, very good pace. Not the best of passing if you're into that kind of stuff, but again, agility and balance is poor, dribbling is kind of poor, but again, he's got very good ball control for a centre back of his build. 85 reactions, 87 interceptions, composure's quite low to be fair, 82. Physicals are off the chart. Jumping really doesn't matter because he is like 6'4", 6'5", or some shit, but yeah. Composure is quite low, but other than that, that's a very good card. Luka Modric coming in as an 87 overall. Wow, minus 3 downgrade for Luka Modric. 4-star, 4-star. Kind of surprising to see, as you see a lot of these Real Madrid players getting upgrades. I don't know if he was injured for the rest of the season or something like that, but 4-star, 4-star, high medium work rates. Never been a shooter. There we go. He's always been a passer, though, and he's always been a dribbler. Very good dribbler, very good passer. Stamina's very good as well for the start of the game as well. 84, very good card. Honestly, I'll definitely use this card, hopefully. Hopefully, EA, if you want to put him in my packs, that'd be very juicy and very nice as well. Oh, my boy! I just seen the first United, second United player as well in there. Soon come. Anyway, Kure Immobile, 3-star skill moves, 4-star weak foot, high medium. This is your classic striker, yeah? When you think of striker, this is what you think of. Classic striker, 93 positioning, 93 shooting, good pace, decent short pass. He can distribute the ball. He can slot away a penalty. Not again, not brilliant agility and balance, but he's not that type of player. He's a hold up player. He can run a little bit if you need him to. He's got decent physicals. He's just a very good, reliable, average striker. You know what I mean? He'll finish for you. He can run a little bit if you need him to. He's got decent dribbling. Not the best, but not the worst. He's got very good reactions, and he can hold off a couple of players. Kure Immobile has always been that guy, man. He'll do bits. He'll do bits, and that's a well-deserved upgrade, I believe, as well, from an 86 overall. I cannot believe they've given this guy a downgrade. As a United fan, I cannot believe they've given this guy a downgrade. I can't believe it. 4-star, 4-star, high. It's like, how have you come to the conclusion to give this guy a downgrade? Like, how? I don't understand. Like, there's nothing to say about his card. Like, again, he's brilliant in terms of pace and shooting, but other than that, he's not really that guy. Very good 4-star, 4-star skill with a weak foot. But I personally, for me, Aubameyang isn't the guy when it comes to FIFA. But in real life, this guy's a bad man. I don't know how they've come to the conclusion to give him a downgrade. But anyway, Bruno comes in as a bad boy 87 card. That's my guy. There's the shot power. There's the long shots. Hoi, hoi. 4-star, 4-star. Hi. 83 position, don't worry. With special cards, that'll come up to a good 90. 89. Oh, that is brilliant. That is absolutely brilliant. Oh my god, 88 short pass, 87 long pass, 86 curve. Woo! 90 vision, 79 agility and balance, which he's pretty much always really had. He's been lurking around that. 86 composure, 85 dribbling, 88 ball control, 86 reactions. Stamina is going to be off the charts as well in the 94s. Oi, oi. Can play him as a centre mid as well. 74 interceptions, 72 marking. Wow, high as well, man. Oi, oi. Oi, oi, my boy coming in as number 32. Angel Di Maria coming in as number 33. Another Messi troll again, still has that dusty 2-star weak foot. I'm just going to skim over him. Again, pace downgrade, I believe, as well. Shooting, possibly a shooting downgrade as well at 81. But again, he's got that dribbling, which is very, very nice. He's got decent passing as well. But again, 2-star weak foot is just dog shit. Honestly, let's be honest. He's not going to go for more than probably like, what, I'd be surprised if he goes for 40k, to be honest, just because of that two-star weak foot. Jadon Sancho incoming. What the fuck? What? 83 pace? What? Eh? I can't remember Jadon Sancho's card, right? Off the top of my head, I can't remember his base card stats. He's had an upgrade, that's for sure. Pace downgrade, definitely, I think. I definitely think that's a pace downgrade, right? Shot power long shots he never really had on FIFA. Finishing at 81, I don't know about that. Don't know about that. Pace as well, I don't know about that. Dribbling has to be up there. Man, again, composure 84. There's always a stat that they like every single year. Last year, it was something to do with centre-backs. I believe it was pace or something like that, where defenders had like the same amount of pace or defending in-game stat. This year, it seems to be composure at 84. A lot of players have that. 77 stamina. I can't believe, again, 4-star weak foot is missing. Pace is missing as well, and shooting. I don't know. I don't see Sancho going for a lot, man. But soon he will have that United badge, I guarantee. Heung-min Son, another one. Coming in at number 35. Skill moves, 4-star, 5-star weak foot, high, still keeps that. Sonny looks like an amazing card, still a little... Is that a downgrade? I don't know, but this card still looks brilliant. Honestly, if this is a downgrade, it doesn't look like it. And again, stamina on point, finishing on point, definitely going as a striker in-game. Very, very top tier card. Luis Suarez comes in as an 87, a minus 2 downgrade, I believe, for him. Still keeps that 3-star skill moves. Pace downgrade, bad. Again, literally reminds me of Karim Benzema, but without the 4-star skill moves and better work rates. Literally, that's all it reminds me of. Better physicals as well, but very similar to Karim Benzema. Probably prefer Karim Benzema now to Luis Suarez, now that he has that massive upgrade. And well-deserved as well. Another well-deserved upgrade. Again, Alexander-Arnold. Very, very good. Even though that does not look anything like an 87 rated card. I'm going to be honest. 3-star skill moves, 4-star weak foot. That does not look like an 87 rated card at all. That looks like an 84 rated card pushing it. Again, passing is going to be on point. Like, this guy deserves like 95 crossing. His vision deserves to be like 87. Curve is on point, passing's on point, dribbling, defending, I'm quite, 79 marking, that needs to be lower, in my opinion. Interceptions, possibly lower as well, they've kind of done nicely. Again, he's a poster boy though, they're going to give him an upgrade, he deserves an upgrade, but them card stats do not reflect an 87, I'm just going to say. Antoine Griezmann coming in next, definitely a pace downgrade for him, definitely wasn't 79. Still keep that 3-star weak foot as well. Medium left foot. Again, there's so many of these centre forward type cards we've got. Yeah, like you've got Suarez, you've got Kane, you've got Aguero, you've got Benzema, now you've got Griezmann as well, and we're only in top, we've not even hit 40 yet. Again, very good, but again, he's not really got the blistering pace. You're probably going to want to play him as a cam again. Decent passing, not the best. Kind of reminds me of Dybala, but without the pace. Not really that bad as a cam, but as a striker, you're probably going to want to avoid him, especially if pace is a thing. Laporte, pace downgrade, definitely. Medium's decent. Good passing, very good reactions, very good composure, very good interceptions. Decent stamina, very good strength, and aggression is decent as well. Very good defensive stats. But again, 63 pace might be a bit shaky for some people. They're probably not going to want to see that. And obviously, Szczesny comes in at number 40 as an 87 rated goalkeeper. I'm not sure what he was. I believe Szczesny was an 86. He was a walkout last year, I believe. So, yeah, let's go into page number 3 and we're going to... Oh. Wait, can we go on page number 3? Hold up. Okay, we're going to start skimming through these because this video is probably like half an hour fucking long. Don't want it to be like that. Right. Roberto Firmino, 87 overall. I'm not going to comment on Roberto Firmino. I personally, I really rip Firmino, but last season he was dog shit. I'm just going to say how it is. 5-star skill move, 4-star weak foot, high. Scream card was so good last year. And again, this card seems very good. Again, another centre forward type card. Very good dribbling. Not like, there you go, the finishing's at 80. Probably want to play him as a centre mid, to be honest. An attacking centre mid. 88 stamina. Or maybe as a cam. Yeah, the cam he'd do, to be fair. Cam is pretty much perfect for him. Low pace, very good dribbling. Very good passing. But shooting isn't there. And he's got decent physicals as well. Bernardo Silva up next as an 87 overall. 4-star skill moves, 3-star weak foot, high. He's a right winger, not a cam. Probably going to take up David Silva's role in the Man City squad as well. Very good dribbling. Poor shooting, but again, that's the type of player that Bernardo Silva is on FIFA 21 and in FIFA in general. Very good passing, very good stamina, just a small nifty player. Again, another 87 rated card, and that's Robertson, man. High work rates. Pace downgrade, I believe, by 2. I think Key should have had a pace upgrade. Robertson isn't slow at all. I believe he was 85 pace last year. So, yeah, I'm not sure about that. Plus 2 upgrade for Robertson, though, again. Decent passing, very good crossing, 90. Decent dribbling for a fullback as well. Very good stamina at 95. Very good defending as well. 84 stand tackle, 82 interceptions, 83 marking, and very good aggression, man. Robson's a very, very good player. Very nice player. Fabinho, again, another Liverpool player. Medium high work rate, perfect. 87 again, plus 2 upgrade for him. Short passing, brilliant. Vision's lacking there a little bit, but long passes there as well. Poor agility and balance, but again, he's got them long legs for 87 interceptions, 86 marking, 87 stand tackle. Yeah, this is going to be a very good card. And Fabinho's always that, not overpowered because he does have a decent rating, but he always performs better than that rating. So I guess, yeah, overpowered. Keylor Navas coming in as an 87 for PSG. SBC fodder Sergio Busquets. I'm not even going to go into his in-game stats because I know they're musty and dusty. Chiellini coming in as an 87 overall as well. That's a minus 2 downgrade. Medium high work rates. I'll still use this card because, again, 66 pace is like my cutoff point for centre backs. Any lower than that, I'll probably not use them, if I'm being honest. Again, he's not that passing type of centre back, that ball playing type of centre back. Very good. 84 composure again, man. Even with centre backs. 88 interceptions, 82 reactions, which are kind of low as well, like Koulibaly. But again, when it comes to defending, woyoy. Stamina's very poor, but again. Centre-back, and when it comes to stamina, it really don't matter to me anyway, unless you're going into extra time. But again, I'll definitely use that card, definitely. Hugo Lloris coming in as an 87. I believe that's a minus 1 downgrade as well. Thomas Muller, in my opinion, should have gone upgrade. But again, stays at that 86 overall as well. Not going to go into him because his card really stays the same. Wow, Paul Pogba is an 86, you know. Fuck me. Okay, these man do not rate injuries this year. Okay, fucking hell. My lord, that kind of hurt. Jamie Vardy coming in as an 86 overall. Now, this is what you call. This isn't an Aubameyang-type striker without the skill moves. He is literally going to be that striker. You play in a 2 up front and he's just going to run, shoot, score. That's it. Running the straight line. None of that dribbling shit. Passing the ball, sprint with him, done, goal. Would have been nice with a 4-star weak foot, but again, he doesn't have that. Doesn't have the high medium or a high low. He has a high. Blistering pace. 92 finishing. 87 shot power. Shot power probably should have been in the 90s, to be honest. No finesse shot, something like that. He's just a traditional old school striker. Again, like I said, 72 agility, 75 balance, 90 reactions though. Again, ball control, in-game dribbling on there. Again, 87 composure is mental. And he's going to have 68 strength. I thought he'd have more than that. Actually, it's the aggression, sorry. Aggression, 87. There you go. A very good card if it suits your playstyle and you know how to get the best out of him. Paul Pogba. Wow, these lot do not like... Do you know what, like injuries, man? But Paul Pogba, here he is. 5-star skill move, 4-star weak foot, high medium, out for the rest of the season. Well, most of the season. Again, 75 finishing, 66 acceleration, but he's got that 79 sprint speed, so he does pick up once you run with him. 90 shot power, 82 long shots, very good passing as well. 91 long passing, 88 vision, very good passing in the midfield. 73 agility again, because he is that tall build. 81 reactions, but then when it comes to actual ball control, dribbling and composure for his build, he's going to be absolutely brilliant with them 5-star skill moves. 89 strength, again, he's just going to be that powerhouse in midfield. So even though he has got that minus 2 downgrade, more or less pretty much the same, to be honest. Marco Verratti, I'm not going to go into him because all you look at Verratti is literally dribbling and passing, and he's very good at that in real life and top tier player in real life, but when it comes to FIFA, he's dusty. Same with PK, 57 pace, ain't nobody looking at that. Alejandro Gomez coming in as a cam again, 86 overall, 4-star, 4-star, high, medium. Again, like literally a perfect card. If it's like this year where small, agile players come up on top, Alejandro Gomez is going to be the one. It's going to be kind of hard to link him. I can't think of the top of my head who we've seen in the Serie A so far in attacking positions, apart from Dybala and obviously Ronaldo, but that's if you've got that top bank. Henderson coming in as an 86 plus 3 upgrade, I believe, on Henderson. High, 3-star, dog shit shooting, very good passing, dog shit dribbling, apart from... Yeah, when it comes to interceptions, he's very good. Probably going to want to miss on Henderson. Probably going to be SBC fodder as well. Doesn't really scream out 86 overall. Carvajal coming in as an 86 again. High work rates. I believe that's a plus 1 upgrade on Carvajal as well. Again, these fullbacks don't represent their rating very well. Not even a stat over 82. And he's got an 86 overall card. I don't understand it. Mahomes, I'm not going to go over because literally 58 pace is all you need to see. David Silva, obviously now Real Sociedad player, 86 overall again. Similar player. He's just a small, nifty player. Very good passing, very good dribbling. De Gea coming in as an 86. That's a minus 3 downgrade. Flipping hell. Rest up, my guy, De Gea. Wow. Okay. Rafa Varane. Again. Still keeps good enough pace. 82 pace. Again, going to be that overpowered guy. 87 interceptions, 18. Oh my god, what a card, man. How's he kept this card? Flipping hell, how's he kept this card? He has been dog shit in the UCL, but again, in the league, he's probably been very good. So again, I can't comment on that. Jordi Alba gets a downgrade as well, minus 1. Keeps his pace very good. High medium as well, keeps that as well. Stamina is very good. Very good card. Very good card for Jordi Alba. He's not really going to be that good defensively though. Jan Sommer getting a walkout upgrade. Okay. Up to an 86. Serge Gnabry. 82 pace. What are they doing to these wingers? I don't get it. Very good acceleration, but then dog shit sprint speed. 4-star. Very good, but it's a good card, but the pace is just dead. 85, like the pace is just gone. I don't get it. Marquinhos gets a downgrade. How? He's been sick for PSG in the UCL. I don't watch Ligue 1. But Marquinhos gets a minus 1. He's very good for PSG in the UCL, man. Like, it's a very good card. He's not got the strength. He's not one of them powerhouse centre backs, but he's just more of a ball playing centre back. But again, gets a downgrade to minus 1. Lukaku keeps his 81, even though, possibly cost into the Europa League, despite his very good goal scoring season. Again, he's just going to move out Optimus Prime. No point. Thiago probably going to have a Liverpool badge on him instead of the Bayern Munich. Again, going to be similar to David Silva, Verratti, them type of players. Very good dribbling. Very good passing, but other than that, doesn't really offer much. Kai Havertz with his Chelsea badge. There he is. 4-star. Doesn't have that 5-star weak foot again this year. Very good shooting. He's probably a centre forward. He's a very good cam. With that pace, if you like tall cams as well. 84 composure. There it is again. He always seems to have one stat that's consistent. Consistent throughout most players. 82 stamina, very good card, man. Very good card. Medium as well. Luis Alberto deserved upgrade. Again, I don't need to say it. David Silva type player. I wonder what his finishing is, though. Finishing 77, never mind. Riyad Mahrez coming in again. Another pace downgrade, I believe. Again, good acceleration, but shit sprint speed. 5-star skill moves keeps that. Very good player, man. Very good player. I'm a big fan of Riyad Mahrez. 84 composure again, man. I swear down. Depay probably going to have a Barcelona badge on him as well. 85 overall, plus 2 upgrade for him. High, low, 5-star skill move. Still has that poor weak foot though at 3. Can this bar fucking move, please? Thank you very much. You're probably going to want to use him as a cam because he don't really have that top tier finishing. Don't really have top tier passing as well, but I'll probably still play him as a cam, to be fair. Just because of that weak foot and not really got that brilliant finishing. But at the start of the game, it probably is got... Oh, definitely, definitely a cam. 78 composure, it's poor. Not really got the agility and balance as well. It's stocky in game and he's got good strength and aggression as well. Donnarumma coming in as an 85 overall. Another Chelsea player, Ziyech, coming in as an 85 as well. 2-star weak foot, so that's enough of that. Marco Reus coming down as an 85 as well. Pace has gone, literally gone. Like I said, they don't like injuries this year, man. Pace has gone. He's still got that shooting. Again, just reminds me of that centre forward type, man. It makes me think, like, is 4-3-3, 4-9 going to be the way to go? This video is going to be literally like an hour long, man. So big up if you're still watching, big up. But this FIFA is looking towards to be like a 4-3-3, 4-9 type of FIFA. Because again, he's not got the pace, but he's got very good dribbling, shooting and passing. Like Firmino has, Suarez has, Aguero has, Benzema has, Lewandowski kind of has as well. Timo Werner, there you go. Here's a good card. 3-star skill moves, but the 4-star weak foot, which is more important to me. High medium work rate, blistering pace, very good finishing at 88. Passing's not there. Again, agility and balance, he's never really been top tier, but again, it's decent. Very good reactions, ball control. Composure 82, he's always had a problem with that. I don't know why. 83 stamina, very good. He's going to go for so much. Especially given that hyperlink to Kai Havertz as well. Again, I like to say the Serie A's version of Paul Pogba. Milinkovic-Savic, high medium, 4-star, 4-star. Decent shooting, not the best though. Very good passing. Again, when it comes to reactions, ball control, dribbling, composure, he's very good. Completing a tackle as well, very good strength and physicals. Wijnaldum probably going to have a Barcelona badge on him as well, but it seems like a very well-rounded card. De Ligt again coming in as an 85. Keep the same rating, I believe. Nothing too special. Seems like, actually, to be fair, that's a very well-rounded card. 72 pace, I believe, as well. Decent at passing. Ball control is decent. In-game dribbling. Composure is, again, low, like Koulibaly and Chiellini as well, I believe, was at 82. Thiago Silva again. Oh, 59 pace. RIP, Thiago Silva. He's down the gutter. There you go. Ricardo Pereira gets a nice, well-deserved upgrade at 85. 4-star weak foot, 3-star skill moves. Nice to see another Portuguese there. Nice little link to Bruno Fernandes down the right-hand side as well. Again, decent pace. He looks better than Arnold. He looks better than Arnold. Again, passing not obviously as good, but very good dribbling. Very good stamina. He's got that pace. He's got very good defending as well. Marking, side tackle, stand tackle, interception is decent as well. Possibly going to go for more than Arnold when it comes to actually how it plays in-game. Yeah, man. Pretty decent. I've had so many fails. Lorenzo Insigne goes back out wide, and that's a minus 2 downgrade for Lorenzo Insigne, man. Wowee. This bar here, yeah, and how sensitive my mouse is. Fucking hell. High, medium, 4-star, 4-star. Again, keeps the pace. Obviously, his shooting never been top tier, but again, very good passing for a winger. Very good dribbling. One below the 84 composure. At 83, reactions have been poor as well, but he's good. Again, depends where Mertens is. We've not seen Mertens at all. So he's got minimum minus 2 downgrade. Pjanic, there we go. Again, one of them players like the passing and dribbling type and nothing really else. Marcus Rashford, my boy, coming in at... Wait. If I don't see fucking Martial here, something's going to happen. 5-star skill moves. 4-star weak foot. There you go. There you go. High medium as well. Lovely. Lovely. Love that. Love that. That's a nice card. That's a nice card. Obviously, I'm going to be biased, but 83 finishing, 90 shot power. Again, he's got winger passing, very good sprint speed, very good pace. When it comes to dribbling, 86 agility. Again, composure is not going to be his thing. 87 stamina. Yes, Rashi, that's what I like to see. 5-star, 4-star. Woi-yoi. Woi-yoi. That's a good card. Leroy Sané coming in as an 85 as well. Card stats-wise, Rashford has more shooting. Roughly the same pace, same dribbling. And Rashford has more physical. So let's see. 3-star week for, obviously, for Sané. High medium. Also, Alphonso Davies and Sané down that left-hand side is going to be dangerous. Oh my god, you could do some nice little Alphonso Davies down the left link with Sané. Sané coming into Havertz and putting Timo Werner up top. Woi-yoi, what a team. Anyway, 81 finishing. Very good pace, obviously. Very good composure at 80. Agility and balance is low as well, wow. Stamina's low as well, yeah. You're probably going to want to go with Rashford instead of Sané this year. Pray I'm not going to go over. Milan Skriniar goes down by minus one, but again, still looks like a very good usable card. Koke, my guy. Enough respect for Koke. But again, at least he's not left mid this year, you know. At least he's centre mid and he's more usable. So again, actually, Koke looks like a decent card. Hold up. High, medium. High. What the fuck am I on about medium? High. Decent shooting, not the best, but definitely not the worst. Very good passing, decent dribbling, 84 composure, 88 reactions. Again, not the best agility and balance, but you can put in a tackle. You've got very good physicals in terms of stamina, strength, and aggression. That's not a bad card, man. That's going to get overlooked a lot. That's not a bad card. There he is, Dries Mertens. Wow, man, what the fuck's happened to him? High, low, 4-star. Has he really had this bad of season? 84 finishing, like, 90. That still looks like a banging card, and I'm still going to use it. 81 composure is a problem, but 70 stamina is going to be a problem as well, but I'm still going to use this card. 84 finishing. Wow, has he really had that bad of a season? Golly. Ben Leno as well coming in as an 85. That's a plus one upgrade. Clement Longley coming in as an 85, again, one of the most overpowered centre-backs again last year. We've also got Leonardo Bonucci. Again, doesn't really look that usable. Frankie De Jong looks absolutely brilliant, again, 85. Medium-high work rates, again, one of my favourite. Probably his team of the year, team of the season, was probably my favourite CDM last year to use. Very good passing, brilliant. Very good dribbling. Again, just don't have the maxed out defensive stats that you really want from your CDM, but he's going to be a very good right centre mid in a 4-1-2-1-2 narrow, helping out the CDM. Again, Rodri doesn't really look that good. Again, Galassi, 85 overall. Toby Alderweireld lacking that pace again. Probably physicals as well. Diego Godin probably going to be a Cagliari player. Definitely not going to have that Inter badge when it comes to next season. Again, lacking that pace. Mario Cardi lacking that pace. Wow, that is a really bad card. Kyle Walker. Martial's not an 85. Are you serious? Are you honestly being serious? Oh man. Also, I'm going to go over Erling Haaland as well because I understand. He's a poster boy, right? I understand. But yeah, and he's doing very well, right? Don't get me wrong, but fucking hell, man. You giving this guy an 84 already? With 87 shooting. I get it, he's a poster boy and they're gonna give him a massive upgrade, but God bless. Aubameyang could do with some of these stats, man. And he deserved an upgrade. Golly, man. No comment on Haaland. I just don't think he deserved that upgrade just yet in terms of FIFA. Christian Eriksen, has he got that 5-star weak foot? Still, he does. Again, just lacking that pace. His dribbling's gone down the gutter as well. Wowee. A lot of SBC for the man that I'm seeing. A lot of 85 rated cards as well. I was expecting to see my boy Martial in here, but He's been dutted on again. High medium, Alexandro again. Looks like, literally, they don't like to give card stats to fullbacks. Again, not one card stat. Very well-rounded card, but again, not one card stat over 81, and he's an 85 rated player. Kyle Walker, the potato, coming in as an 85. Is that an upgrade for Kyle Walker? I think that's actually an upgrade for Kyle Walker. How? How? High work rates, which is very good for FIFA wise. Very good pace. Passing's dog shit. Dribbling's absolutely dog shit. Defensively, other than stand tackle and slide tackle, he's dog shit. Stamina's good. Strength's good. Aggression's good. He's gonna move like an absolute train though, but honestly guys, that's gonna be it for the top 100. I'm sorry and I'm very surprised if you're still here. It's probably literally near an hour. I'm just gonna quickly check. Can we see anyone else? Like, can we see like data not found, suck your mum. But yeah man, is there anything else literally before we come off this? Best La Liga player, best striker, best Bundesliga player, best fullback, best Premier League player. Let's see if we can get some more out of this, man. Bench. Nah, we can't see more, unfortunately, that we haven't seen already. But hopefully the whole database does come out soon. But yeah, guys, that is the top 100 all in one go. Let me know what you think about it down in the comments below. And let me know if you disagree with anything that I said. I'll be reading the comments as well. But yeah, guys. I'm very surprised if you're still here, but if you are, thank you very much for sticking through. And streams will be coming back shortly once the database does come out. We'll be making more content for you lot, hopefully going through some starter teams for you lot to build, depending on what budget you roughly have. But yeah guys, that is going to be the end of the video. If you did enjoy, hit that like button, subscribe for more FIFA 21 content coming through on the channel in the near future. But for now guys, that's going to be it. Thank you for watching and peace. I don't need a gang, I was all free, man, nigga. I don't need a crowd. Roll it style. Fresh from the head straight down. I got the gallon going. I tried to teach you Guapanese, but you couldn't speak it. Came for the peas, then I'm gone, I'm leaving. Linking up for weeks, and you didn't.